Hello, I'm JP and welcome back to the channel. If it's your first time here, may wish to consider subscribing. Before I start, I'd like to give you a big shout out and thank you for watching my channel. I'm approaching 1,000 subscribers, and without you, I wouldn't have a channel. My channel is nothing. So thank you very, very much. So today's video is technically a bit of a hashtag questions, but not a hashtag questions, as I've received a couple of messages and comments relating to my cable boxes that I've had in a few of my gig logs. So let's do this. I have now had a few comments on some of my gig logs and some questions asking what is the box on wheels I store my cables in. And as I have a couple of them, they're actually called Stanley cases. I think they are designed for tradespeople to transport their tools around. But I find them absolutely useful and perfect for storing cables and other little important bits that I need from time to time at the gigs. Personally, I like these cases. They are very portable and have several handles, additional storage areas. As you can see, I make use of those additional storage areas. And one of the important things is they're not particularly expensive to buy. They are available from eBay and Amazon. And probably in light of the current climate, I'd say check out your local suppliers as well. See if any of those have these boxes available. One of the biggest problems that many DJs face is that they have to get their cables out of the box at the next gig. And if they're throwing them all in their bag or box, then they could be all tangled and you can't see what cable you need for what setup you're doing. So personally, I like to fold them all up and put them all away neatly, because that does mean that I get to be able to set up quicker. It reduces my pack down time, but not dramatically. And overall, it's a win-win situation because it means I only need to pull out the cables I actually need. One of the biggest issues that we all have as DJs is what to do with the cables in the boxes. Now, personally, I have a way of folding all mine up. Some of them I have little bits of tape for because they're too long. Other ones I tie around themselves. What I can do is show you how I do mine. Everybody can do their own way, but this is how I find them easy to do. So small plug wire here. What I do is fold it in half again, and then turn it round, wrap it round, pull it through. That now fits in my box without getting lost. XLR cables, they're a bit longer. What I do is I get these little ties from Amazon. They're just Velcro. And what I do is get the XLR cable that's too long to tie together by itself and double it up like that. End to end until gets to a point where it's nice and small, and I just simply wrap the Velcro around it, and there we go, that goes into the case. Smaller XLR cables can tie together. These are like 3 meter ones, I think. Do it, there we go, fold together, double up, and then once you get to a point where it's only so big, you can literally loop it round and then pull that through like so, and there you go, that keeps itself nice together. This stops long plug them all getting tied up and tangled up in your boxes, so when you get to pull them out to use them again and again, they're there and they're ready. It takes a little bit longer to pack away, but it's well worth it when you go to set up for the next time. So 5 meter plug cable, double up again, double up, and it's so long, literally just round and through, and you just pull the loop through like so, and that goes in the bag. And then we've got all cables in the box or bag, whatever you use, and they're easy to pull out and easy to get to. I hope this video has been useful for you and interesting, and that you can actually use it practically in one way or another. And hopefully you might want to consider, if you're not already, subscribing, or alternatively liking or sharing, and that, because that's all what makes this channel work, and that's really appreciated. At this point, I normally would link to one of my other videos or suggest you view a playlist of mine I have created, but instead I wanted to share this little video that I saw on social media the other day, and it made me smile, and in these times there's not much smiling happening, so and it also made me laugh. Listen to the lyrics if you haven't heard it already. Enjoy, be safe, JP out.
So I'm kinda scared just standing here. There's lots of talking, lots of singing without protective gear. So all your germs are in the air. I watch the news in disbelief, 'cause I've been to China, Italy, and to Tenerife. All this info scaring me. I sterilize, I sanitize, my hands are always feckin' dry. There's just so many things that I can't touch, I'm torn. How do I use the lift? How do I get the door? I hold on to my bags, 'cause all the germs are on the floor. And when I take the train, I stand using my core, 'cause I don't know who the hell has touched that pole before. I wanna isolate, I wanna go back home. I'm kind of being paranoid. Shaking hands, hugs and kisses, we must sort of avoid. What was polite is now not right. Blame Mr. Chong and Mrs. Wong. It won't be long till Shaggin's gone. There's just so many things that I can't touch on. How do I use the lift? How do I get the door? I hold on to my bags, 'cause all the germs are on the floor. And when I take the train, I stand using my core, 'cause I don't know who the hell has touched that pole before. I wanna isolate, I wanna go back home. Blame Mr. Chong and Ping Pong. Please tell me what went wrong. Just so many things that I can't touch, I'm torn. How do I use the lift? How do I get the door? I hold on to me bags, 'cause all the germs are on the floor. And when I take the train, I stand using my core, 'cause I don't know who the hell has touched that pole before. I wanna isolate, I wanna go back home. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there's only one line that you do not want to hear in any of your households, and that is this.